Sunny and Finn's Wrestling and Video Game Podcast. This week we talk about the PlayStation 4K rumors, Final Fantasy 15, and everything WrestleMania.
Hello everybody and welcome to episode number 8 of the Sunny and Finn Show. I'm Sunny, and with me as always, the artist formerly known as Turbo, Finn Steele.
Hello.
How are you, my friend?
I'm very well, thank you.
Good.
How's the intro?
A few bits to talk about today. Obviously, this is our post-WrestleMania podcast. But we've got a bit of gaming news as well to talk about. And we will go into detail with NXT, WrestleMania, and the Raw following WrestleMania.
Yes.
Let's start with gaming, because it seems like it's been a while since we actually talked about gaming.
Yeah, a little bit.
What are you playing at the minute?
I just got done playing The Division. Hit level 13, kind of got bored of the end game, and kind of thought, yeah, screw it, I'll move on. And I actually bought a Dreamcast from a local game shop.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, love Dreamcast.
It's the best console. One of my favourite consoles ever.
Same here. A lot of nostalgia for it. I love it. Shenmue is awesome.
Shenmue is very awesome.
And I'm playing Quantum Break on the Xbox One, which is excellent. I love it.
Yeah, absolutely.
How about you?
I've also hit the level cap in The Division. Mm-hmm. Finished all the story missions and stuff like that. You are right in what you're saying. The end game is pretty boring. I've done all these sort of missions and stuff. What am I going to do next? But the additional content's coming out soon, so I'm going to crack on with that. Cool. I'm playing Dirt Rally on PS4.
Hardcore.
Which is good.
Awesome.
But it's very unforgiving.
Yeah, that's what I heard. I heard it's like a proper simulation rally game.
It seriously is. It is really good though.
Yeah, I mean, I like the old Dirt games.
Yeah.
I'm not huge into simulation races. I'm for like arcade type things, but
Cody's make amazing racing games.
They do, he does.
And they always have. I mean, like from the original Colin McRae on the PlayStation all the way up to sort of now, I mean, it's awesome.
Heck, Micro Machines on the Mega Drive was amazing.
I love Micro Machines on the Mega Drive.
With I have
the two controller ports in the, the cartridge.
Yeah. Awesome. We should play that.
Yeah, we should. That's awesome. And I am also playing Quantum Break.
Yeah, awesome.
On Xbox One. It's great. I love the TV show aspect of it as well. That's really cool.
It's cool.
They've done it very well.
Yeah.
And it's not cheesy like I thought it was going to be.
No, it works quite well.
Yeah.
It's got that guy who's in everything. As one of the bad guys.
Oh, yeah.
I forgot what his name is.
Yeah, he's in Game of Thrones. He's like Littlefinger in that.
Oh, yeah.
But he is literally in everything. He's right at the beginning of The Dark Knight Rises as well.
Yeah.
It's in about 10 minutes of that. And just before we sort of started recording, Finn helped me out, beat Bloodstarved Beast on Bloodborne. So I'm going to crack on with that because I've been doing it for ages.
Yeah.
This guy comes along and wins straight, like second time of asking.
Second attempt.
I've been doing this for ages.
I've played a lot of Bloodborne, what can I say?
But that son of a bitch is dead now. He's not coming back.
He ain't coming back. No new game plus.
I'm going to go light that lantern and I'm going to go back and I'm going to crack on. So yeah, that's what I'm playing at the minute.
Awesome.
Lots of different stuff. The backlog keeps growing.
Yeah, it's bigger and bigger.
I know you had a bit of gaming news you wanted to discuss today.
Yes. So there's been a lot of rumours, speculation about PlayStation 4K or PlayStation 4.5, whatever you want to call it. Sony's next console, sort of an upgrade to the PlayStation 4. So they reported, I think Eurogamer came out and reported that this thing is real. Sony's not said anything officially yet. But then another person on the popular website, forum website, NeoGAF, came out and said, well, this is everything I know. And it's like this verified guy who's supposedly legit. I've got what he said down here. Let's have a look. So the price is going to be somewhere between $399 and $499. Quite expensive. The GPU is apparently twice as powerful as the GPU in the current PS4. And much faster. So that's something. You could be seeing like 60 frames per second on the console, which would be nice. It comes with Blu-ray 4K, if you're into that. PS4K will upscale games that are not natively 4K to that resolution. So that's something. it's coming from someone who doesn't have a 4K TV and just not really interested in 4K at all.
Yeah. Now that we're no longer a PG show, fuck this idea, right?
Yeah.
I'm not into this idea at all.
Me neither. I mean, it really depends for me how much of an improvement it gets the games get performance-wise. I'm not bothered by 4K in the slightest. It's going to be a long time until I get a 4K TV. I mean, you just bought my new TV.
This, in my opinion, this is something that should have been thought about when the PS4 was originally coming out. 4K technology has been around for long enough now for them to sort of be able to put this, you know, in with the PS4 before it even came out.
Yeah.
Think ahead. Don't bring something out 3 years down the line because you think it's moving with technology.
Yeah.
It's just a fucking brain dead idea. People can't afford to fork out for all of this crap.
I agree. I think what they're trying to do is to try and keep up with like PC a little bit. Because when PS4 and Xbox One came out, they were somewhat underpowered compared to what PCs were doing at the time. As you said, I don't like the idea. I would much rather stick on my original PS4.
The problem is, right, we didn't need to move on from the PS3.
Yeah.
Right, or the Xbox 360. We did, and obviously we got the PS4 and Xbox One. If it wasn't ready, and if you wanted it to sort of move forward with new technology, just hold it off.
Mm.
You know, if you really want people to play games in 4K or whatever, you know, just wait, release it after a little while longer. You know, take longer to release it. Don't just bring it out because you feel like you need to bring a new console out.
Yeah.
I understand that technology moves forward very quickly, but I think what consoles need to, it just needs to accept that it can't move as quick as PC gaming.
Yeah.
You can't just upgrade. Because, you know, people have, especially if it's going to be sort of, was that $499?
Yeah, $499.
Right, so it's going to be like, what, £400 here?
Probably.
I've just bought a 1 terabyte PS4.
Yeah.
I have no interest in buying a 4K PS4.
Yeah. Me neither, to be honest. Apparently it's also going to improve PlayStation VR. Again, for me, it depends how much it improves it. If it's only like a slight upgrade, then I'm not too bothered.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a list of games here which it might improve
on. It's going to improve something that isn't even released yet.
Yeah, it's true. Apparently, at least day of as well, is apparently Q1 of 2017. So it's going to be after
the PS4K.
Yeah, so it's going to be after the VR.
See, somebody asked me about this on Twitter, and I said it might sort of arrive around the same time as the VR. That's what they're sort of wanting to do with it. But no, I'm not happy about this. I don't think a lot of PlayStation gamers will be happy about this.
No.
I don't think it's a smart move on Sony's part.
No, I think Microsoft are planning to do something similar as well, which is...
Well, I think they were they've been pretty coy about it. They've not really come out and said that they would. They would only need... They only would if it was sort of something they had to do.
Yeah.
And honestly, I don't think it's something that they have to do.
I agree. I don't think there's life on these old consoles yet. It feels like when you just got them. It's been, what, 3 years since you got them?
Yeah, I mean, the PS4 still seems new to me.
Yeah,
I mean,
me too.
The fact that they're still making PS3 games, it tells you everything you need to know about how new this console still is.
Exactly, yeah.
I don't think... this isn't something that needs to happen now.
No.
I'm just against it. I think it sucks.
It does suck.
I'm not buying a new 4K TV for it.
No, me neither.
It's an SMIC, that's what that could be.
Yeah.
Yeah,
certainly can.
Because, you know, if you want this experience, you know, if, I mean, the games, there isn't going to be specific games for this new console.
No, any game, they're saying any game that comes out on PS4K will be compatible with PS4.
How good of them.
Yeah, so you're not really losing out on anything. And then maybe a slight performance dip. Maybe frame rate won't be quite as good. Resolution won't be as high as whatever, but I can live with that.
Yeah, I could also live with it.
Yeah, I mean, if they hadn't come out with it, we'd be doing that anyway, so...
Yeah.
Who cares?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, anyone who plays on an Xbox One is sort of used to frame rate dips and graphics are, you know. I mean, the Xbox One isn't even keeping up with the PS4 as far as performance is concerned.
Yeah.
And Xbox, there's nothing rumoured, not properly, and not as heavy as the PS4K at least, for them to be bringing an upgrade out for that. They just keep improving the console as they go along with software updates.
Yeah, that's true.
Just do that.
Yeah, why not? But yeah, the games they mentioned will be getting an upgrade. You've got the VR games, Eve Valkyrie, a game called Robinson, which I don't know what that is. And
called what?
Robinson.
Robinson.
Yes, like the juice.
Right.
It's not squash. also, it's a drinking squash simulator.
Oh yeah, that sounds great. It's like Job Simulator. Sounds what magical.
Something that does look pretty fun though. And also GT Sport, which is quite a big one.
GT Sport, is that
it? Gran Turismo Sport, yeah.
Oh, Gran Turismo.
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry. When's that out?
Don't know.
Oh.
Probably around the same time as VR, I'd imagine.
Oh, is it a VR game?
I think so.
Oh, is it?
And or at least it has like VR
compatibility.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, okay.
Maybe like look around the car as you're driving, which would be pretty cool actually.
I'd be interested to see how a new Gran Turismo actually does, because the last couple have been fairly disappointing in my opinion.
Yeah, same. Because I'm not a huge simulator fan, as I said earlier, but
they need to sort of take the Forza Horizon formula and make a Gran Turismo game fun like
yeah.
that.
Forza Horizon is great.
Really fun.
It's very fun. I love it.
Yeah.
One of the first games I bought my Xbox One.
Yeah. It's so good. Even though Sean Maguire is doing the voice acting, which is weird, but it's awesome.
Yeah.
Do something fun like that. I mean, how much life can you really get out of Gran Turismo as a simulator now?
That's true, yeah. It's been done. You also mentioned the game Deep Down, which is a Capcom game.
Oh, okay. I have heard of that, actually.
Yeah, it's been on like radio silent for ages. We heard nothing about it. I think everyone assumed it was cancelled. But now it's just kind of come out of the blue, which is pretty cool, because that's still a thing.
Yeah.
Also, God of War 4, we're going to
take a chance
of it, who cares.
See, I like God of War.
Yeah, I like God of War, it's fine.
It's fine. but I know that, I don't think it's going to be Kratos now.
Oh, yeah?
I think they're going to go sort of Norse mythology instead of Greek mythology.
That'd be cool.
They've done Greek mythology to death. I mean, there's four console God of War games.
Yep.
And if you factor in the two PSP games,
yep,
which are also very good.
Yeah, they're good.
You know, that's a lot of Kratos and a lot of Greek mythology.
It is.
So I think it's time to move forward. I mean, they're still going to be doing mythology, but they're going to go with Norse mythology. That's the rumour. Nothing, again, has officially been announced.
Yeah, but that would be cool. I like Norse mythology. It sounds good to me.
Yeah. See, I like Greek mythology a lot.
Yeah, I mean,
that's
I like both.
That's why I like God of War so much. But, yeah, you know, it's time to try something different.
Yeah, why not? What else happened? So Final Fantasy 15 had a event. Sadly, it was like middle of the night, so I didn't see it. But they announced the release date, which is September 30th. Hooray! So that's actually a lot sooner than I thought. Nice and early.
And it's awesome as well. The demo, it's like a tech demo, isn't it?
Yeah, pretty much.
Just to show off what it's going to be like. And I've played it. I mean, I'm not a big JRPG guy.
I am.
As you know, but
yeah,
I'm
a huge JRPG guy.
I downloaded the demo, and you know, I spent quite a lot of time with it, sort of you know, running around checking out the environments, which are absolutely stunning.
So good.
So good.
Can't believe it's adorable.
And it's just awesome.
Yeah.
I'm going to buy it. I mean, I bought Final Fantasy Type-O HD.
Oh, yeah.
On Xbox One after I played it, because I wanted more Final Fantasy. I was like, oh, this is awesome. Now I want to play more. So yeah, I'm going to get that. I'm definitely going to get it.
Yeah.
It's so cool.
Yeah. I don't think you'll be disappointed. It looks amazing.
I like now that it's not turn-based combat. I like that it's sort of real-time combat. Okay. I don't know what JRPG purists think about it.
I think JRPG purists, not myself personally, I'm not too bothered, but I think JRPG purists prefer like turn-based and classic like JRPG stuff.
Because in Type-O HD, it's real-time combat as well.
Yeah, yeah. But I love the combat in 15. I think it's great. I think people were concerned it was dumbed down a bit in the latest demo, but I think that's just because it's like a tech demo. You don't need like super complicated.
I think in a way they want to make it accessible for sort of old players and new players.
Yeah, that's fair. I wouldn't be surprised actually if they had like two different combat modes, like an easier mode and like a or hardcore mode with added tactics or whatever.
Yeah, an easy mode for idiots like me who just want to go windmilling through, you know, fantasy creatures and stuff, that's I'm fine with. And then for the hardcore like Finn you know, other JRPG purists, maybe go something a bit more in depth.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they do that,
because they want this game to sell. I think I don't know why, but I've just got a feeling there's a lot riding on it.
Yeah, same. I think they mentioned like I think it was corrected later, but someone said they needed to sell like 10 million copies to like
to break even.
Not to break even, but to like deem it a success. But then they corrected later and said, "Oh no, that's just like a high goal. That's like best case scenario type thing." But yeah, that's a lot of copies.
That's a lot of homes.
Yeah,
playing Final Fantasy 15.
It certainly is.
I'll be one of them. You'll be another one. But yeah, it looks very, very cool.
It's very cool.
Yeah, so what I was going to do is run down the releases that are coming out this month.
Okay.
So we're in April at the minute. It's the 10th of April today.
New games of the month.
Yeah, more games to add to the backlog.
Yeah. Hooray.
Yeah, so we've already had Quantum Break, Enter the Gungeon, and Dirt Rally on PS4 and Xbox One this month.
Mm-hmm.
Enter the Gungeon's PC and PS4 only.
Oh, I've never even heard that one. You honest?
It's supposed to be really, really good.
Cool.
It's supposed to be sort of painstakingly difficult, so you might even like it.
Yeah, you never know.
So this week, so we're on April the 10th at the minute, so this is week commencing the 11th of April.
Okay.
Okay, we've got Dark Souls 3, which is obviously the big one,
mm-hmm.
which I have pre-ordered, which you already have.
I do own it, yes. Came early, thank you. Shop 2.
It's going to destroy me. I know it is.
Probably.
But I love Bloodborne, so, and I am looking forward to playing this. It looks gorgeous.
Yeah, that's great.
So can't yeah, wait. I'm definitely looking forward to playing it.
Mm-hmm, me too.
Sort of. In a it's going to upset me sort of way.
Yeah. Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Yeah, exactly. that Ben Affleck face will actually be me. Yeah. I'm sitting there on Wednesday morning, like after I played it for a day, and I'm going to be so miserable. The Destiny Spring update is also released on. Sorry. Dark Souls 3 comes out on the 12th of April, which is Tuesday.
Oh yeah.
And that's worldwide.
Cool. Do I like it?
The Destiny Spring update.
It came out in Japan earlier, but yeah.
Oh, of course, yeah. So Western release,
yeah.
So America and here, 12th of April.
Yeah.
Okay. The Destiny Spring update on PS4, PS3, Xbox 360, and Xbox One. Also comes on April the 12th. I do still own Destiny.
Cool.
I think I played it for like an hour the other day.
Nice.
I have no idea what I'm doing at the minute because I've got missions and crap all over the place.
Yeah. They did improve it a lot, I heard, in like updates and stuff.
It's amazing now.
Yeah.
It's really good, yeah. I'm amazed that there's still life in it.
Yeah.
Like when he first came out and he wasn't that great, Destiny purists will hate that.
Yeah.
What? What do you mean it wasn't great?
What?
It wasn't. It wasn't
great. I love playing the same missions over and over and over again.
Yeah, but it's massive now. There's so much to do.
Yeah. I should get it again.
Yeah. Have you not got it?
I had like the original version with no like DLC or anything.
Yeah, same. And then I rebought it with The Taken King, which like you said you probably would do with The Division.
Yeah, I probably will.
So that comes out on April the 12th. I can't remember exactly what it brings to the table.
Yeah.
Just cool new stuff. So just take it as quite a substantial update as it's advertised as a game release in itself. So
yeah, more about will be.
Ratchet and Clank comes out on PS4 on April the 12th in America.
Yay.
And us schmucks over here have to wait until the week after.
Boo.
I'm not going to do that.
No.
I'm going to be impatient and I'm going to buy the American release.
Why not?
Fuck the system.
Right? Yeah.
Yeah. Stick it to the man. That's what we're doing. More. Bloody hell. Tuesday's stacked.
Yeah.
Fallout 4 Wasteland Workshop DLC.
Awesome.
Comes out on April the 12th. PC, PS4 and Xbox One.
Cool.
You've got the season pass. I'm assuming it comes with it.
I do. It is. Yep.
I haven't played it in so long. I'm going to have to start all over again because I did put it on and I was like, what am I doing? What is this? I remember nothing about it.
It's one of those games where if you don't play for a while, you can come back to it. It's like, I am completely lost. I have no memory of anything.
Yeah. it's a great game. I mean, it's just massive and overawing, maybe?
Yeah.
For a first time. Because I was a first-time Fallout player
when
I came into Fallout 4, so I just got lost. I'm still lost. What else we got? What else we got of any worth? Star Fox Zero comes to Wii U on the 22nd of April.
Oh, cool. Okay, didn't know about that one.
Are they backwards compatible ones? Are they old ones?
No, Star Fox Zero is a new one. Brand new for the Wii U.
So what's Star Fox Guard? Because that comes out the same day.
That is a game that comes with it. I think it's like a little mini game. I'm not entirely sure.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah.
So Star Fox Zero is the brand new one?
Yeah, it's a brand new Star Fox game. That's cool.
Quick side note. I've read that Pokken Tournament hasn't done great.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, which is a real shame because like most Wii U stuff, it's amazing.
Yeah, it's great.
And there's just not enough Wii U consoles in homes to maybe justify bringing games out
big
releases anymore. Going forward, maybe towards the end of the year. Because I know there's stuff on the release slate, but...
Still, it's rumoured to be announced this E3, so...
I think they'll save the PS4 announcement until then as well.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah. What else we got? The Alien Nation for PS4 comes out on the 26th of April.
Cool.
Looks very good. Dungeons 2 comes out on PS4 the week before that, on the 22nd of April. I'm not sure what that is.
Same.
The second episode in the new Hitman series is out on the 26th of April as well.
I actually quite like the look of the new Hitman. I know we talk crap about it before, but It kind of intrigues me a bit.
We did. I mean, me and the guys in the comments, we slated it. When we played the beta, I played the beta and we did a stream for it. And, you know, it wasn't impressive.
Yeah.
Like, it just felt like the same old Hitman rehashed again.
Yeah, kind of.
I have bought episode one since, and I have started playing it, and it is good. It's fun.
Yeah.
When you sort of understand it and how it works and stuff like that, and, you know, you start becoming good at it, because like most things, I haven't got the patience and I suck at it so badly.
Yeah.
But it's good. And it's Paris, the first episode.
Oh, yeah.
And you have to sort of, like, you can go down the catwalk and stuff like that and dress in this as like a supermodel and stuff. Awesome. It's really cool. It's fun.
That's cool.
Episode two is Italy, and that comes out later on this month.
Awesome.
There's a game called Lost Reavers coming out on the Wii U.
All right. Okay. Take your word for it.
Yeah, fine. excuse me if I'm not pronouncing this right, but Yo-Kai Watch.
Oh, yeah. Is that not out of here yet?
29th of April in Europe.
Oh, right. It's been out in America for ages.
Really?
Yeah. It's like a Pokemon type game.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. That's for Nintendo 3DS.
Yeah.
That's pretty much it for April. May's big, but we'll go into May when we do our May-ish podcast.
Yeah, okay.
But, anything else you want to add gaming-wise?
I don't think so. That's about it.
Okay. Before we go into our wrestling segment, I just want to say thank you to everybody who came to the streams that we did over the weekend. It was our first WrestleMania weekend as a podcast.
Yes.
We feel it was very successful.
It's very good.
We did the stream for NXT on the Friday before the show. And that was great. A lot of people sort of joined us in the comments and came to chat with us and stuff like that and ask us questions. And then we did one for WrestleMania on the Sunday with two friends of the show, John and Steve. And thank you to them as well. And we also had a lot of fun doing that one as well.
Yeah. Probably the best ladder match in 2K16 history.
Yeah, I agree. Definitely the funniest ladder match in 2K16 history.
Yeah.
It's really mind-blowing that people want to come and ask us questions about wrestling, want to come and talk to us and ask our opinion. And it's also mind-blowing where people watch it in the world.
Yeah, like guys from all over the place.
Yeah, like Dubai and Canada and America. It's crazy, but we do appreciate it. And that's why we like to sort of create the new content and do the streams and everything like that. So thank you.
Much more to come.
Okay, so WrestleMania was this past weekend.
Sure.
Weekend
was.
Just gone. Well, last weekend now.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Let's start with NXT on the Friday. What we'll do, we'll talk about our predictions. We'll talk about the shows and the matches that were on the shows and stuff like that. I'll let you take the lead on this one.
Cool, okay. Right, so we've got NXT. I think it was Apollo versus Elias Samson in like the pre-show thing.
I don't even think it was on the pre-show. I think it was shown on this week's NXT.
Oh, right, okay. Haven't seen this week's yet.
There's only one match and it's that.
Oh, cool. I guess I need a break after that weekend, which is fair.
Yeah.
It was Apollo Crews versus Elias Samson. I think I said Elias Samson would win. You said Apollo Crews would win. And Apollo won. So, you know, not surprised. I thought they might go with Elias because they want to get him a bit more over as a heel.
Yeah.
But no, he's just a loser, apparently.
Yeah. Apparently he's just going to be sort of one of them people. Maybe they realise he just isn't over.
Yeah.
And that's it now, and that's just going to be him going forward.
It's 100% gimmick.
Yes.
That's 1 point to Sunny, 1 point, no points to Finn.
Ting.
Ting.
Yep. I'm not surprised that Apollo won.
No, I'm not.
I haven't seen the match itself, but I imagine it didn't last very long.
No, I don't think so. But yeah, good on Apollo. Saw him down on the main roster, by the way.
Yeah.
I thought it was a bit early to put him up.
I'll talk about this in a little while. I've got same with him and Baron Corbin.
Yeah. Okay. That's cool. So then the first match on the night was Austin Aries versus Baron Corbin. We both said Austin Aries would win. And we were both right.
Ding, ding.
Ding, ding. So it's 1 point to me, 2 points to Sunny.
It wasn't actually the first match on the night.
It was not?
No.
Which one was it?
American Alpha against The Revival was the first match.
So it was. What do I know?
That's fine. We'll just go. We'll go in the order that we've got it on here.
Yeah, yeah. That's fine. So, I thought Austin Aries and Baron Corbin was a good match. Baron Corbin got most of the offense in. I think it just existed to make Baron look strong.
I think so, yeah. But also Austin Aries give him the win as well.
Yeah.
I enjoyed the match. I think it was my least favourite match on the card that night.
Yeah, me too.
It was awesome to see Austin Aries. And I've become a fan of Baron Corbin sort of fairly recently.
Yeah, same.
So, yeah, it was good. The correct result, get Austin Aries off the mark.
Yep.
Obviously, especially with Baron Corbin moving up to the main roster.
Yep, definitely.
Which we'll talk about shortly.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, it was a fine match. Yeah. Some cool spots, and I was happy to see Austin Aries win.
Yeah, definitely.
It'd be cool to see how they book Austin Aries going forward.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, Austin, I would like to see Austin get like more offense in, just to, like, show off what he can do.
Sure.
Because it's probably the first time a lot of people are seeing him actually wrestle.
He needs to find somebody around his own size as well.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
Obviously, Baron Corbin could be... I mean, Austin Aries is a great worker anyway, so I don't think it matters as much. But, you know, it'd be cool to see him go against the likes of Finn Balor and Nakamura and people like that.
That'd be so cool.
That'd be so awesome.
Okay,
yeah.
So good. We'll get to that.
Yeah.
So yeah, the first match of the card, as you said, American Alpha versus The Revival. I said American Alpha would win. You said The Revival would win. And American Alpha won. That's another point to me. 2 points each.
Ding.
Great
match as well.
So good. So good. I love both these teams. They're both great.
I can't remember why I said that The Revival would win. I think it was so that they could sort of get a bit of longevity out of this feud, but I think they still probably will because they'll get a rematch. So.
Oh yeah, for sure.
It was a really good match. It's been awesome. So because I usually spoil everything for myself, so when I woke up in the morning, sort of avoided my phone and watched the whole event sort of without spoilers. I think I actually cheered when American Alpha won.
Yeah, I think I
don't do that very often.
I think I clapped or something.
Yes, get in. It's like, I was really happy. They deserve it and they're amazing. Absolutely.
Yeah, I love them.
And they'll carry that division going forward.
For sure.
100%. But great match. The Revival, you know, they were great as well.
Yeah, they have one little awkward move.
But I mean, he was forgiven pretty quick. I mean, I saw it and I was like,
quick WrestleMania chant, and then they got over it.
Yeah. Yeah, they got over it pretty quick because whatever they did next was amazing. So,
yeah.
Yeah, but it was awesome. I was so happy to see American Alpha win.
For sure. So good. Right, so after that, probably the match of the weekend, the match of the year, perhaps the millennium. Sami Zayn versus Shinsuke Nakamura. We both said Nakamura would win. Of course, getting both right because. Of course you would.
I can't gush about this match.
Yeah. It definitely made me a lifelong fan of Nakamura and Sami Zayn. It was, amazing.
Everything from the entrances up onwards was amazing because they were both sort of goosebump-inducing entrances because obviously the fans were singing along to Sami Zayn's entrance theme, and that was a really nice moment because obviously it's going to be his NXT send-off.
Yeah.
And then when Nakamura's entrance music kicked in, and I was like, holy shit, this is absolutely amazing and surreal. He comes out and his entrance is awesome. And I don't know, it was just... And when he did his signature pose by the ropes, the crowd, the roof pretty much came off.
So good.
And I was like, oh my God, this is a seriously awesome moment. It's like my girlfriend, she'd never seen Nakamura before. And she's a big Sami Zayn fan.
Yeah.
And she's like, God, this guy is... so weird but also very cool. And
very cool.
It's, oh man, the match itself was hard hitting.
Mm-hmm. Very hard hitting.
Both got great offense in. King of Strong Style is he's pretty much hits the nail on the head because them elbows that he hits and the kicks that he does are just something so else.
Yeah,
but it was a really great back and forth wrestling match.
Yeah, it was so good.
Love the Fight Forever chant.
Fight Forever.
That's about right.
Yeah. I could watch so that much forever. Awesome. Oh, and that count we did just to Sammy's corner dive thing.
Yeah.
And it kicked him in the head. That was so well timed and perfect.
Yeah. It was absolutely awesome. But everything was great. I mean, it's like when he did the Blue Thunder Bomb and, the count. I mean, we knew it was going to kick out, but how dramatic it was. And, we could probably talk about this match for as long as the actual match went on itself.
Yeah. It also shows that you don't need, some stupid, poorly written storylines to get two people to fight. They had, no feud into this.
And literally nothing, yeah.
And it was the best match, ever.
And the most hyped up as well. Build-up or anything. It's like, right, Sami Zayn's going to fight Nakamura. And we were all like, shit, really?
Yeah, sold.
Yeah. Straight away, we're fine with this.
Take all of my money.
we weren't like, why?
No.
Why is this happening?
Yeah, it's not like Roman Reigns versus Triple H. Here's this convoluted, stupid story reason why they're fighting. Cause it's,
yeah. He just doesn't need to be like that. And it was an amazing match. Match of the year so far.
Yeah.
By some distance.
by a mile, yeah. Not to discredit any other match on this card. They're all amazing matches.
But if you ask most wrestling fans, they will tell you that match was incredible. Something to behold. Yeah. It really was. Go back and watch it. If you haven't seen it, I mean, I've revisited it a couple of times now.
Same.
Just because of how good it was. Yeah, go check it out. Nakamura's entrance theme is amazing, by the way.
It's amazing, yeah.
And it's actually number one on the iTunes chart for soundtracks at the minute, yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So yeah, that was amazing. I might go and watch it later on, actually.
Yeah, me too.
Just for no reason.
But yes, after that amazing match, we had another good match. It was Bayley versus Asuka for the women's title, which is great. Sunny said Bayley would win. I said Asuka would win. I was right. Asuka won. That's 4 points to me and 3 to Sunny.
Ding.
Ding.
Really good match again.
Yeah, great match. It's almost a mirror of Sammy vs. Nakamura in some ways.
Yeah, I think so. It was just a really good back and forth women's wrestling match.
Yeah, it was great. They're both obviously super over. A lot of people love Bayley, obviously, and Asuka.
I think that was sort of shown in the crowd as well. I mean, yeah. The crowd were they seemed very pro Bayley, but I don't think they can really make their mind up because I know that a lot of people, including myself, wanted to see Asuka win the women's championship. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, I really like Bayley.
Yeah, we wanted to see Asuka win, but we didn't want to see Bayley lose because people love Bayley.
Yeah,
it's like when at like the end when she passed out and it rang bell, bang, you saw people's faces drop and like, oh, yeah. We're happy that Asuka won, but oh, poor Bayley.
Yeah. I think that's exactly the sort of I think that's the feeling that I felt as well. I was like, I really want Asuka to win here, but I really like Bayley.
Yeah.
So it was a tough one, but as long as we get to see the match again,
yeah,
whatever the next takeover is, then I'm happy with that. It would be good to see Bayley make the transition to the main roster soon. I thought that might be the reason she lost.
Same.
She didn't appear on Raw, so that's obviously not the case.
Yep.
So
disappointment.
Yeah. A really good match, one that went opposite to how I predicted.
I'd say Asuka would win for that very reason. I thought Bayley would be going to the main roster, but not yet, it seems. But probably soon.
Oh, I think so, especially with this new renaissance in the women's division that they seem to be very happy with.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, sure.
And then after that, we had the main event. It was Finn Balor versus Samoa Joe.
When you think about it, this was a pretty short... thin card.
Yeah, it's quite a small one.
As far as matches go, but I mean...
Yeah, it doesn't need to be, like, massive.
Well, that's it, yeah. Like, the stories told themselves.
Exactly, yeah.
This match was amazing.
It was great.
I was disappointed with the result.
Yeah, surprised, but shocked that, like, he bled so early and had to keep going off to the side and getting it patched up and all that.
I think it added more to the match. I think it added sort of... I mean, the crowd were obviously, you know, fuck PG and all this sort of stuff. Even Linda McMahon was cheering it in the crowd.
Oh yeah, I saw.
What's funny is she was sat with Stephanie.
Oh yeah. Oh man.
She's sticking it to the man as well, clearly. But I thought it was good. I thought that there was like one chant that was like, "Let Joe bleed."
And
Joe
was
like running his head along with it.
Yeah.
But I was surprised that Joe didn't win because he's been booked like a monster. But going into this match,
we both said Joe would win. By the way, and both get a point. Ding ding.
Yeah.
I'm surprised.
We both said Joe would win.
Yeah.
So neither of us get
a point. I need to get a point.
There we go.
Sorry.
Great match again.
Great match.
Back and forth. You know, when finally they let them go and they, I think they just sort of figured out they weren't going to fix Joe's eye during the match. So they just like, forget it. Just let him go for it.
Yeah.
I think, we were expecting, I think the reason we thought Joe was going to win is because we were expecting Finn to sort of make the transition to the main roster.
Yeah. So yeah, there were a lot of rumours going around about Finn Balor possibly turning up in Mania along with Balor Club / Bullet Club. But turned out that didn't happen, sadly.
No. No, but I don't know. I mean, it will happen eventually, I'm sure of it.
Oh yeah, I'm sure.
But I was disappointed that Joe didn't win. I thought it was time. But I think maybe they don't want to follow the same pattern they have been doing.
Yeah, maybe.
Right, so the champion has it for a while, then they take it off him, that champion goes to the main roster, comes back for the rematch, loses.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe they wanted to sort of... I mean, I anticipate Joe winning this title at some point.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah. And then Finn will eventually make the transition up to the to the main roster, I'm sure of it.
Yeah.
But for now, you know, wasn't to be. Not just yet anyway, but the show itself just showed how you can put a wrestling show on without all the crap that comes along with normal WWE productions.
Yeah, definitely.
It was a six. I think it ended up being six matches, or was it five?
One, two, three, four, five on TV, six at the show because of Apollo was our last.
So five. It was a 2.5 hour show as well.
Yeah, I think
just
so.
About.
Just about.
So I mean, they filled 2.5 hours with five matches.
Yeah,
five excellent wrestling matches.
Yeah, and all great.
Yeah, this was a good show. One, I mean, these days I don't really tend to go back and watch the shows as much. I sort of rewatch the shows.
Yeah.
But this one I've already sort of rewatched Sami Zayn and Nakamura, and I will do it again. But I will rewatch the whole show because it was excellent.
Mm-hmm.
It was really, really good.
I agree. Love it. More please.
Yes, much more please, 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 please. I know Nakamura's on next week's NXT.
Great. Awesome.
But I think it was filmed WrestleMania Access possibly over the weekend.
Could be.
Yeah, I can't quite remember, but I think he fights Elias Samson actually.
Oh really? Yeah, cool.
So I wonder who's going to win there.
I wonder.
Maybe the Drifter with an upset.
Yeah. Your guitar or something.
He's like Jeff Jarrett.
Yeah.
Did you enjoy your WrestleMania weekend with us?
I did. It was great.
Yeah.
A lot of fun.
It was a long show, wasn't it?
Boy, was it. Like 45 minutes over what they said.
Yeah.
Ugh, jeez.
Well, by the end, we were like, Jesus Christ.
Yeah,
just end. We know he's going to win. Just end.
I think I got up after the match and started putting stuff away. It's like, I don't care about this match.
Everyone putting their coats on to go.
Yeah.
It's halfway through the match. So that brings us to WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Okay, so we did our stream at 8 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
We went all in. We watched all of the pre-show.
We did.
So there's a few network issues at the beginning of the pre-show, I think, actually. But soon, very, very quickly sorted out. People were bitching and moaning on Twitter and stuff. Oh, my God, the network's crap. Oh, it's like, remember there's people that have got this for free.
Yeah, so yeah.
There's more people than usual watching this, and it's WrestleMania.
Exactly.
But it was sorted out very quickly. So we watched all the pre-show. It was just, you know, the video packages that were going to be shown.
They're talking with the crowd. I'm going to kick some ass.
Yeah. There's always that one imbecile in the crowd who's like dancing and making a scene of himself.
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Booker T making noises.
Yeah.
This is crazy.
Oh, Booker T. Yeah. I'm just as the pre-show is going to like the USA network, I think. So it was coming off. They were staying on the network, but there was a portion of it that was going to be shown on TV in America as well.
I think some sort of technical difficulty. They like cut to a camera, there was nothingness. They came back and like Renee Young was like, oh, blah, 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 whatever. And Booker T was like, makes this weirdest noise.
We all exploded in laughter.
Yeah.
Just loving our lives. And we must have repeated the noise about 50 times during the course of the night.
Yeah. Oh, Booker T.
Classic Booker T. Shucky ducky quack quack.
Oh, God.
I hate that crap.
I do too.
It's nonsense.
You see, we've got its own little stupid animation.
Oh, no. It's just...
Hate it.
Why?
Yeah.
So the first match on the pre-show was... I don't know what it was.
Was Kalisto versus Ryback, was it?
Oh, yeah, it was. Yeah.
Okay.
And it wasn't even a bad match.
It was fine.
There wasn't many people in the crowd to see it, which was a shame as well.
Like
because
12 people.
Yeah, you know, there was a few people in the crowd, but, you know, which was a shame because I like Kalisto a lot.
Yeah, me too.
Not so stoked about Ryback, but the match itself was actually quite good considering it was a pre-show, go out there and perform in front of no one.
Yeah.
Sort of thing.
Yeah, no, I thought it was pretty good. Kalisto, I think I said Kalisto would win. You said Ryback would win. Kalisto won, so that's another point to me.
Ding.
Ding.
So if you're keeping score at home, what are we on at the minute?
That would be 5-3 to me.
Right, okay.
Yes, I've got it in a bit different order here, so it's all a bit,
Fair enough.
But yeah, so that many.
It was a good match. I mean, both got their their moves and stuff in. It was standard pre-show stuff.
Yeah,
nothing too special for WrestleMania. It was fine.
Yeah, it was fine.
Yeah,
medium.
That's basically it. It was just fine, and you know, we were fine with it. We watched the match. We enjoyed it, and yeah, it was fine.
Yeah, cool. So after that. I think it was it Usos versus Dudleys or let's see. Was it Total Divas versus Bad and Blonde?
Total Divas versus Team Bad and Blonde was the second match, I think. Okay. Yeah, it was. It definitely was.
Cool. Okay. We both said Total Divas to win and we were both right because it was Brie Bella's last match.
Did we get added bonus points for saying that Brie Bella would get the pin?
I can't remember. Yeah, sure, why not?
She won by doing an amazing transition into the yes lock.
Yeah, probably the best I've seen her do it.
Yeah, for sure. Even Daniel Bryan even tweeted about it.
Oh, yeah.
Saying like she did it better than him. but the match was okay.
Yeah, I mean, it was fine. Everyone did the thing. Even Marie did a little backflip thing, which is nice for her, I guess.
Yeah, she looked okay in the match, actually.
She wasn't that bad. She's been practicing.
Yeah, she's been doing well.
She's practicing that one move over and over again.
Yeah.
And nothing else.
But Lana came in. It was interesting, actually, to see Lana come and sort of be an in-ring competitor for the first time.
Yep. She did a good few kicks.
Yeah, she didn't do a lot. The kicks looked fairly dangerous, but I don't really have a problem with it because they looked good.
Yeah,
they
looked good.
And I don't think anybody was hurt. I've seen people bitching online like, oh, God, why is she coming in and just doing these kicks? What's the point in that? Right, you have to start somewhere.
Exactly, yeah.
You can't just come in and like have a bloody a move set that's going to rival AJ Styles.
Exactly. It'll be good if she's maybe spent some time at NXT, maybe. I don't know. Maybe she will, maybe she won't.
I don't think she will. I think she'll sort of have a few matches on Raw, maybe.
Okay.
You know, she looks the part. I mean, she's obviously gorgeous.
Yeah, she looks great.
But she looked fine. The kicks looked fine. And yep. I don't really see people's problems. If she didn't hurt anybody and the kicks were part of her moveset, then who cares, right?
Yeah, it's fine. No problems.
But Brie won with an amazing version of the Yes Lock.
Yep.
She did like a forward roll. I can't remember who she tapped out. Possibly Naomi?
Sure, why not?
Yeah, okay.
Let's go with that.
Either way, Brie Bella got her. And then Nikki Bella came down.
Oh, yeah,
in her ring gear for no reason.
Yeah, what was the point of that?
In a neck brace. So she was never going to wrestle, so the... I don't know, maybe did they tell her to wear her ring gear just in case no one knew who she was?
Yeah, maybe. Who's this weird woman that looks just like Brie with bigger boobs coming down?
Yeah, it was weird. I never understand that. No. Like Wade Barrett standing at ringside in his wrestling pants and his elbow pads and he's not even doing anything.
Yeah.
So weird. But so Brie Bella got her send off. She went quietly into the distance.
Yep.
That's fine. I'm happy for her.
Yeah. We spent too long talking about that.
Yeah.
Next, after that, we had Usos versus the Dudley Boys. We both said Usos would win, and I'm pretty sure the Usos won, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, okay. They lost on Raw, didn't they? Yeah, that's right.
Good, yeah.
It was a bloody, I don't know, it's nothing match.
Oh, they put the Dudleys through a table, didn't they, at the end of this?
Oh, yeah, they did. And I'd like Bubba Ray turned face for no reason halfway through the match, and started doing 1, 2, 3, get the table, this whole thing. And like,
yeah.
He's like, you're supposed to be a bad guy.
The Dudley Boys are in a weird place at the minute.
They are.
A very weird place. I don't know. That match was fine. None of us were excited for it. We just wanted to watch WrestleMania.
Yeah.
So by this point, we were already 2 hours deep into the pre-show.
Oh, God, yeah.
We were like, come on, let's just watch WrestleMania now. It was fine. You know, followed the tag team match formula. And the Usos won, and that's fine.
Yeah. It's average.
Was it Devon that took the pin again?
I think it was, yeah.
Yeah, that's standard. I'd like to see the Dudleys maybe split up and have Bubba Ray go on his own.
Yeah, he was really good in the TNA as a bad guy. So I'd like to see that.
Yeah, I would as well. I'd like to see them bring in Velvet Sky.
Oh yeah.
And have them go with that, because obviously they're a real life couple.
Cool.
Somehow.
Yeah.
But yeah, maybe have Bubba Ray go on his own, because the Dudleys are literally a spare part at the minute, in my opinion.
Pretty much.
So that was the pre-show.
Yeah, that was the pre-show. It was fine.
Yeah, it was fine.
Binge review. It was fine.
Yeah.
After that, first match of the night was the ladder match. We'd featuring Sami Zayn, Zack Ryder, Kevin Owens,
Stardust, Sin Cara,
etc. Sin Cara
and Dolph Ziggler.
And Dolph Ziggler, yes, and one more. So I don't remember. Yeah.
Someone else. It was good.
Yeah.
Very spot heavy, as anticipated. A lot of really hard bumps in this match.
Yeah, a lot of really good ones. A lot of really good moments.
Someone came off the... I think Sin Cara came off the ladder through another ladder to the outside that I think Stardust may have been on.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Through Stardust to a ladder.
So there's a lot of serious bumps in this match. It was a really good match. It was also our first match on the stream as well.
Yeah.
So we sort of predicted that. We'll take that one.
Hooray.
Yeah.
Also, I said Sami would win. You said Owens would win. Zack Ryder will be one.
Yeah.
So neither of us have got a point there.
It also turned out to be a very pointless win, but we'll get to that. Yeah. But Zack Ryder got his WrestleMania moment. Mm-hmm. You know, based on sort of what happened the night after. I don't even know if Owens is even going to come back into this title picture anymore.
Yeah, it's a mystery.
We'll see. But it was a really good match. Sami Zayn did some really cool spots. He did the did like the swan dive through the ladder the outside, which was awesome.
Crazy. He also
and then he did straight after, did his tornado DDT.
Oh yeah, that was awesome job. He also suplexed Kevin Owens onto that ladder, which looked really painful.
What was it? The, like the exploder suplex.
Yeah, yeah. He's like snapped his neck.
Yeah, it was a crazy good match. As I knew it would be. I mean, there's so much talent in the match that it was going to be hard for it to be crap.
Yeah, it's a shame that Neville wasn't in it because he got injured. But
next year, I think he'll get his moment next year.
Yeah, for sure, he will.
But it was a good match, and they gave Zack Ryder his WrestleMania moment for whatever reason.
Yeah.
Oh, The Miz was in it. The Miz was the person.
Oh yeah, The Miz, of course.
Of course, yeah. But you know, it ultimately was fairly pointless. But again, we'll get to that in a little while. But good match.
Yeah, very good.
Yeah.
Right. What do we have after that? I honestly. It's AJ Styles versus Jericho next.
Is that the next one?
I think so.
Oh, that sounds right.
Yeah. We both said AJ would win, and we were both wrong. Jericho won for some reason.
It was a good match.
Yeah, really good.
It's probably was it? Do you think it was their best match out of all them?
Yeah, I'd say so. I think so.
Yeah, I mean AJ was awesome. Told a good story during the match as well. Some really good close falls, near falls, whatever you want to call them.
Yep, yeah.
AJ hit the 450s, or the springboard 450, which was awesome.
Yeah, crazy.
Did the Styles Clash as well?
Yep. Yeah, we kicked out off.
Yeah, didn't AJ kick out of a codebreaker though as well?
Oh yeah, I think he did.
And got out of a couple of walls of Jericho's.
Yeah, that's true.
So there's some really good moments in the match. The Jericho won as AJ was coming off the rope to do the phenomenal forearm.
Yep.
Jericho caught him in the codebreaker.
Yeah.
Which Finn actually called just as he before it happened.
Yeah. So I said him and Jericho.
But it was really, really good match. I was disappointed that AJ won, but obviously what happened the night after made me happy and made up for it sort of. So it was a really good match.
Yeah.
I hope that is the end of that feud now. It needs to be.
It must be. After what happened, I think it must be.
And I think they're going to sort of push Jericho on to do something different, hopefully, and same with AJ Styles too. So in the end, it didn't really hurt AJ Styles when you look at the bigger picture.
Oh, no.
And it certainly didn't do anything to stop Jericho's phenomenal run. So pardon the pun there.
Yeah.
He's really on a great run at the minute, Jericho.
He is, yeah.
His best working years. I keep saying it's his best working years, but it truly is.
It really is, yeah.
Yeah.
So good. Right, after that, let's have a look. What was next? Was it New Day next, or was it the women's match?
No. The women's match was well up the card. I think it was New Day.
Oh, yeah, I think it was New Day. New Day had an awesome entrance coming out with Siri Box.
Yeah.
Dressed as Saiyans from Dragon Ball Z, which is amazing.
Which I know you loved.
Yeah, I loved it.
There's a video doing the rounds of when the Bootio's box tips over.
Oh, yeah.
Like, you can see them running from from behind the stage to sort of get there to do their entrance.
Nice.
But it was very cool.
Yeah.
They're so over at the minute, the New Day.
It's so good.
They deserve the big entrance at WrestleMania.
Was wrong.
I can't remember who we said would win.
We both said New Day would win. And we're both wrong again. No points.
Yeah.
And for some reason, the League of Nations won. Weird.
Very weird. Was it 4-on-3 in the end, or was it a 6-man tag team match? I can't even remember.
It was a 6-man tag, and Wade Barrett was just wandering about outside
in his pants. Yeah, but it was a fine match.
It was fine. Yeah, it was decent.
One thing I will say about WrestleMania, it was a good wrestling show.
Like, it was.
All the matches were good. The booking decisions and the results were
weird,
questionable.
Yeah,
and it's fairly interesting to say the least. But it was a really good wrestling show.
It was.
This match was no different, really. I can't really remember too much, you know, in detail about the match. I haven't been back and rewatched WrestleMania 32 because, you know, as
long.
Fine as it was very bloody long.
Yeah, it was bloody long.
Yeah.
But yeah, I remember enjoying the match. As you said, I don't remember an awful lot about it. I think it was in good spots. Like, they did the big ending double team thing, which I think counted.
Yep.
I think which gave them the win. Gave the League of Legends a win.
Yep.
But then after that, the legends came down. Stone Cold Steve Austin,
of course, yeah.
Mick Foley and
forget
Shawn Michaels, which is awesome. Seeing them in the ring,
yeah, it was awesome. It was like when obviously the League of Nations did like a promo afterwards, and they were like, "There was no one that can, no three men back there that can stand up to us, even though there's four of them."
Yeah,
but that's fine. And then
wait, about like guys,
yeah, hello guys, anyone? No. And then Shawn Michaels came down in his ring gear.
Yeah.
We were all like, holy shit, is this going to happen? Is this really happening? Then Mick Foley came down.
Yep.
And we were like, oh, well, who's the third one? And then we went, oh, clearly it's going to be Austin.
Yeah.
And Austin came down. It was awesome. I've seen people, people bitching online that Austin didn't come down in his pants.
Yeah.
But why are you hell-bent on seeing Austin in his pants? It's awesome enough that he was there.
Exactly, yeah.
It wasn't an official match.
No.
So he doesn't need to knee pad up. But it was awesome to see.
It was great, yeah. He did a lot of stunners, a lot of super kicks, a lot of bits of taco.
Yeah.
And then Xavier Woods got stunned afterwards, which is great.
And it's like, it was quite funny because obviously they were all dancing in the ring. So they kicked the League of Nations, you know, kicked crap out of them. And then the New Day came back in the ring and Xavier Woods pushed his luck, got a stunner for his troubles, and they had a beer bash.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I love it.
It was pretty good. So that was a lot of fun.
You can tell Xavier loved it as well.
Yeah, oh, for sure. The selling he did for the stunner was hilarious too.
It was great, yeah.
So that was really, really cool. We were all sort of on a big high after that.
Yeah, definitely.
Because I don't know, the pacing of Mania was weird this year. So
it was.
But it was a really cool moment. I like how they do these moments every year at Mania.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, Austin loves being amongst it.
Oh yeah, for sure.
So that was awesome. Mick Foley is in great shape as well.
He is actually. Yeah,
he's in really, really good shape. So, that was cool.
Yeah, great. Right, after that, what was next? Was it Dean Reschbach next?
Well, yeah, I think you're probably right, yeah.
Yeah, okay. So, we both said Dean to win. Once again, we were both wrong.
This was a weird WrestleMania for results.
It was.
We went into this and we were like, Dean winning would do less damage to Brock than if Brock won.
Yeah. For sure. And it would put Dean over in a big way.
Yeah.
But we were wrong, as it turns out.
Yeah. It was a good match, though.
It was fine. It was probably the one I was most looking forward to that disappointed me the most, because it was very short, I thought. It could have gone a bit longer.
Yeah.
It's kind of... Yeah. I mean, it was fine.
Yeah, it was good. I mean, you know, the chainsaw came out, didn't it?
Yeah.
But I don't think Dean could start it.
Yeah, he revved it up twice and thought, screw it, can't do it.
Yeah.
Threw it away. Said, well, that was pointless.
But it was good. It was, you know, standard Brock Lesnar doing suplexes. And
yeah.
German suplexes and the crowd counting along and all that sort of stuff.
At one point, he tried to do suplex Dean Ambrose on a bunch of chairs and overshot and landed on chairs himself and Dean Ambrose just flew over it. It was quite funny.
But it was a fine match. It served its purpose. It, you know, realistically, at the end, it was a card filler.
Yeah, I guess so.
And that's what it was.
It's a shame because they both said better.
Yeah, I agree, yeah. But, you know, with Brock Lesnar, I like Brock Lesnar a lot, and I've always been a big fan of him since he came in to WWE way back.
Yeah, yeah.
But the suplex thing, there's more to him than that.
Yeah.
Like, when he first came in, he was sort of doing the triple backbreakers.
Oh, yeah.
And he was doing, you know, like a double powerbomb and stuff like that, and making himself look a real powerhouse. Now he's sort of a one-trick pony.
Pretty much, yeah.
The Suplex City thing is fine, and it's fun and everything for the crowd to count along, but...
It's getting old now.
I don't want to count along at home. I want to see better moves. I want to see more moves.
Exactly.
But Brock won. I don't think we'll see him for a little while.
Probably not.
He was backstage at Raw, but they had nothing for him, so... he wasn't backstage at Raw. He flew home straight after WrestleMania because they had nothing for him on Raw.
Ah, fair enough.
Didn't want to waste his appearances by having doing something meaningless.
Yeah.
So I expect to see him back in a couple of months' time, probably. Cool.
Probably.
Clearly got the easiest ride of anybody who's well-paid in WWE.
Yeah, definitely. Get rid of him, I guess.
Yeah.
Right, then... I can't remember if it was the Battle Royal first or the women's match.
The women's match was first. Match.
Okay. It was Sasha versus Charlotte versus Becky.
Yep.
Once again, we all both said that Sasha would win, and we were both wrong.
Again.
Again, Charlotte won.
So earlier on in the night, on the pre-show, they had Lita, which we didn't mention actually, they had Lita.
Oh, yeah.
Looking no different to what she always does.
Yep, looking
absolutely
great.
Gorgeous. Come out and unveil the new Women's Championship. Obviously, this had been rumoured before WrestleMania. We thought it might happen on Raw the night after, but it made... Well, I think it sort of made sense. I mean, they had the official unveiling of it on Raw.
Yeah.
So, I mean, they announced it, and it's cool. The belt itself is awesome.
Yeah, it's great. I like how it's like equal to the men's belt.
Yeah, just different colours.
Yeah, it's recolored, which is it's fine.
Yeah, absolutely fine. It's awesome.
Yeah.
It also means we'll be able to recreate it in WWE 2K16 very easily.
Yeah, it's true.
So that's very cool. But yeah, I mean, Sasha got a special entrance.
Yeah, that's awesome.
The girl singing was pretty crap.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, pretty out of tune, but fair enough, she's had a moment in front of a ton of people.
Yeah.
Then Snoop Dogg wrapped Sasha Banks to the ring, which was also fine.
It's pretty cool, yeah. And Sasha has had Eddie Guerrero's ring gear.
Yeah.
Which is cool.
Yeah, very, very cool. Good match. Really, really, really good match.
One of the best matches of the night, I think.
Yeah, for sure. Some hard hits. Becky took a real walloping, as you could see the day after on Raw.
When, big black eye.
Big, big black eye. I think Sasha was hurt as well.
Oh, was she?
A little bit, I think. So, yeah.
But yeah, it was an amazing match.
Yeah, it was a really good match. Charlotte won by cheating again. I mean,
bloody Ric Flair.
How much longer are we going to have to put up with this?
Yeah, I know. It didn't ruin the match, but it kind of made it feel a bit like, oh man, really? They're doing that again?
Well, it's just a cheap win.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
So Charlotte won. I think how it went down was Charlotte was doing the figure eight on Becky Lynch in the ring.
Yeah.
Sasha tried to get in, but Ric Flair held her back.
Yeah, she grabbed him. I think Sasha jumped on Ric Flair early in the match or something.
Yeah.
Like, jumped over top rope.
Oh, she did do, yes, because Becky was sort of talking to her outside, shouting at Ric Flair outside.
Yeah.
And I think Sasha maybe did a suicide dive outside the rope.
I think you're right, yeah.
Yeah. So good match. Really good effort from all three women. Best women's match on the main roster for quite some time.
Yeah. When was the last time you said the women's match was in the best matches on the night at WrestleMania?
Okay, fair enough.
Not for a long time. Or ever.
Yep, I'll take ever.
Yeah.
If this is how the women's division is going to be going forward, then I'm very happy for that.
Yeah, me too.
Because that's two women's matches this weekend that have just been outstanding that we wanted to talk about.
Yeah, absolutely. I also loved Sasha's frog splash on Charlotte and Becky in the figure four. That was great.
Yeah, it was awesome. The problem is, obviously, they know that Becky, Sasha, and Charlotte are the three figureheads for the women's division.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. It's just, the fear is, I mean, obviously, in NXT, there is people that can come up and make it amazing.
Mm.
But on the current roster, on the main roster at the minute, it's difficult to see who's going to really fly the flag for the women's division outside of them three.
Natalia's very good. Emma's pretty good.
Oh yeah, fair enough.
Paige is pretty good when she wants to be.
Yep, shut my mouth. There we go. That's
that's three, at least three more.
Yeah, but I mean, I'm sort of thinking sort of like Alicia Fox isn't great. Yeah. She's fine. Brie Bella's now gone, and Nikki's due to come back.
Yeah, she wasn't that great ever.
See, I disagree with that. I think really? Nikki's got a lot better over time.
Yeah, she's definitely got better for sure. But I think compared to the others, I don't know. Not that great.
Fair enough.
Who else we got?
I like Nikki. I love the bum wiggle.
Oh, yeah. Can't say anything bad about the bum wiggle.
I don't know if anybody, whoever watched the stream, you'll notice me wearing a Brimo t-shirt.
Oh, yeah.
Brimo. I just bought a new Balor Club t-shirt and Finn came in his Balor Club t-shirt.
Yeah.
So I thought, right, I'm going to go for comedy value here and wore my girlfriend's Brimo t-shirt instead.
Nice.
Yeah. Which is now hanging up in the section, in the wrestling t-shirt section in my wardrobe. So
awesome.
I'll bring it out again.
Expect that again, yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Cool.
But yeah, so Charlotte won, and it was such an amazing match. Go back and watch it. Best Divas match, women's match, should I say, on Raw on a pay-per-view for quite some time.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
I agree. So after that, we had very late in the card, just later than we expected, the Battle Royal, or not a giant Battle Royal, starring lots of people. Surprise entrant of Baron Corbin.
Yep.
As well as, what's his name? The guys.
Oh, Shaq.
Yeah, Shaq as well. And,
Tatanka?
Tatanka, that's the one. He's kind of, who remembers him? Not me.
I remember Tatanka not being that big, but I remember him.
He's grown a bit.
He's grown a touch, yeah. This is the biggest shock of the night.
Yeah, for sure.
Obviously, Baron Corbin won.
Yeah, good to see Baron Corbin there.
Which was amazing. It was refreshing to see, because we all had Mark Henry to win this match.
Yeah, after Big Show last year.
Who did you have? Did you have Mark Henry?
I expected him to win, but I didn't want him to win. I said Tyler Breeze or someone.
You said Tyler Breeze because you didn't care. That was it.
Yeah.
Mark Henry spent most of the match outside of the ring. I thought he was just going to come in and win the match.
Yeah.
He didn't. I don't know if he's injured or anything, but...
Who knows?
It was cool to see Shaq. I like Shaq. I enjoyed the angle a couple of years back when Shaq and the Big Show were sort of going at it.
Oh yeah, he is huge.
He's massive and it's awesome.
Yeah.
So it's cool to see Shaq. As stupid as it is, and wrestling fan purists will be like, oh God, why is Shaq in there? It could have been for somebody much better, but it's WrestleMania, these things happen, and Shaq's cool. I mean, I'm happy for anybody who loves wrestling to be involved in these sort of things.
Yeah, sure. But it's great to see Baron win.
Yeah.
That's how it should, this battle royale should be done. Put over someone new and make them look great.
I didn't, because obviously Baron didn't get an entrance.
No, he didn't.
Just walked down with everyone else.
Yeah.
But, which I think that's funny because, like, right, we're all about to beat the crap out of each other, but we'll all walk down the ramp civilly together. In a civil manner, we'll all walk down, and then we'll all get in the ring. Then when the bell rings, then we'll fight.
Then we'll fight, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, so it was really cool to see. I mean, I think Kane threw out Mark Henry.
Oh, yep.
Then Baron Corbin came from behind and threw Kane out.
Yeah.
And it was awesome. We were all shocked.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
It was the only time we were shocked in the night, I think.
Pretty much.
But yeah, it was great. It was good to see. I've become a Baron Corbin fan fairly recently, so
yep,
I think it shocked the crowd as well.
Yeah, yeah. No, it was great. What was next? Oh, after that, had a big match. Shane versus The Undertaker.
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
Was this after the Battle Royal?
Yes, yes, I think so. Pretty sure it was.
I don't think it was. I think Battle Royal was right before the main event.
All right, could have been. I can't remember. It was very late, very early in the morning.
To be honest, yeah. Like I said, we haven't been back and rewatched it. We've sort of watched it once, read the backlash on the internet and sort of followed it all and everything like that. Don't get me wrong, I enjoyed the show. I enjoyed the evening like with Ben and, you know, my other friends. And it was good, but it was just weird.
It was very strange.
This match is no exception.
So again, we both said Shane would win. And we're both wrong, as usual.
Yep.
For this card. But yeah, it was a pretty decent match, actually, surprisingly.
Yeah, it was good. I mean, it made Shane look really cool.
Yeah.
Like, it made him look really good. Like, he got a load of shots in. Stood toe-to-toe with The Undertaker.
They call jump on the corner into the ladder or into the trash can.
Coast-to-coast. And he actually flew as well, like...
Yeah,
he actually did it better now than he did the last time we saw him.
Yeah, yeah, great.
So, you know, it was awesome. And obviously the big talking point of the match was when they went up.
Yeah.
It was when Shane went up, rather.
Yeah, right up the top and they jumped off. And
insane stunt.
Crazy.
Really, really crazy stunt.
Crazy, crazy man. How are you alive?
Very risky. Like, risking it just to sort of for our entertainment.
Yeah.
And that's why I love Shane McMahon.
Exactly, me too.
It's so good. It was when you see it back and like you see how high up that really is. Yeah. It's like
bloody hell.
Yeah,
I could not have done that even close. I couldn't even stood up there. I got halfway up and nope, not doing it.
But you know, he didn't even connect with Undertaker. Obviously, Undertaker moved and Shane went straight through the table.
Yeah, it was like the table wasn't even there. The table was like evaporated beneath him.
Pretty much, like it was basically he might as well just jumped onto paper.
Yeah, pretty much,
because that table just gave
immediately.
Like,
yeah,
it gave way big time.
That must have hurt like hell,
but it was awesome.
Yeah, and he was still able to like move around and finish the match. And
yeah,
crazy.
And it was really, really cool. And they got back in the ring. There's a few more blows traded between the two, but Undertaker obviously won.
Yeah,
so obviously that whole angle was to set up that big spot.
Yeah, all completely pointless.
So like, Shane, can you come back, do a big spot, and then,
yeah,
you know, go again?
Yeah.
Yeah, fine, no problem.
Weird. Very strange. I don't get it.
But it was awesome to see.
Yeah, it was great.
I was just disappointed that Shane lost.
Yeah. We both want something to change on the main roster, because it needs it.
Mm.
We've been stuck with the Authority forever. It's been done to death, and we just want something new, something exciting to happen.
I think Raw... did sort of bring change. Let's talk about the main event first, because we have to.
Yeah.
And then we'll talk about Raw the night after. There's a few talking points from Raw.
Yeah, for sure. So, Roman Reigns versus Triple H. We both said Roman would win. And shockingly, we were both correct.
So form didn't go against us in this one.
Yeah. As much as we wanted to be wrong about this one.
Yeah.
We weren't.
Yeah. I mean, at this point, it was like... 5-4.
Oh god,
AM in the UK when this match started, and we were like, Jesus.
It's going to be like a 5-minute match or what?
Yeah. It's like, this is usually over by 4, and they went an extra 45 minutes. And Triple H's entrance was weird.
Yep. Stephanie McMahon came out looking pretty good.
Yeah. Well, why not?
And did this whole thing, oh, Triple H is good and great, and this is the best, and this is going to beat you up. That's like the whole crowd of people. Of like people with animation thing with like the mouths sealed shut, which I guess is supposed to represent the WWE universe, which is cool but creepy.
Yeah, then they had the, then Triple H came out.
Yep.
And he had a load of people in masks with him.
Yep, yep.
Yeah, it literally was NXT superstars and yeah, stuff like that. Because Finn Balor was there.
Was he?
Yeah, Finn Balor was one of them. And stuff like that. So, yeah, it was an interesting entrance. Triple H always has a massive entrance at WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's part of the reason he's there, I think.
Pretty much, yeah.
Just to get his WrestleMania entrance. Did Roman Reigns have much of an entrance? Oh, he had that stupid thing where he punched... He did like the Superman punch taunt on the or the superhero landing taunt.
He pressed down on the D-pad.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, and then the video screen on the ramp.
Oh yeah,
pretended to sort of rumble like an earthquake sort of thing.
Yeah,
it did look pretty crap, to be honest. I mean, it's a cool idea, but I don't know.
Had way too much fireworks going off outside the arena.
Jesus, that was stupid. Actually, I forgot all about that.
Like 5 minutes worth of fireworks. Like, yeah. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, 72's one, for Christ's sake.
Yeah.
It's like, he punches the floor. He gets fireworks in the arena. Then it cuts to the video screen outside the arena. People in Dallas must have been like, what?
What's going on?
Oh, WrestleMania's over. No, just Roman Reigns' entrance. So weird. But
yeah, lots of booze. As to be expected.
Tons of booze. I think WWE muted the booze.
Yeah, they did some sort of sound witchcraft and made it sound a lot quieter for us watching. But from all accounts from people there, it was definitely that loud booze.
Yeah. I mean, I think you could sort of tell, because I think Triple H sort of turned to Stephanie during Roman Reigns' entrance and said something, but, acknowledged how ridiculous the booze were.
Yeah.
The match... I was so tired at this point while I was watching the match. Maybe I should have gone back and watched it again.
Yeah.
But it was okay, I guess.
It was an average match. It wasn't a WrestleMania main event. It was like a payback main event. It felt like.
And will be the payback main event. Probably,
yeah. we know who's going to be next, but we'll talk about it later.
Yeah. I don't know. It was fine. The match literally just served its purpose of making Roman Reigns champion.
Yeah, pretty much. It's a sledgehammer. Stephanie got speared. And then Roman won. The end. I think he won with a spear.
I think he won with a spear, yeah.
Nothing major.
No, nothing great. Nothing we knew much. It was going to happen. We knew it was coming. But we know that Roman Reigns is going to be the guy going forward.
Yeah. I think we both hoped something would happen, like Battle Club had run down or something, or someone new would come.
We were holding out hope.
Yeah.
But hope didn't deliver.
Nope. Just a big waste of time.
Overall, WrestleMania was fine. Out of 10, I would give it 6. What's your score out of 10 for WrestleMania?
Probably like a 6 as well. 6.5.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Out of 10, we didn't do it for NXT. What would you give NXT out of 10?
11. probably a 10. I can't see it getting any better.
I mean, the only misstep... It wasn't even a misstep. I mean... My least favourite match was Austin Aries against Baron Corbin.
Yeah.
But
it served its purpose, I thought.
It's a 9.5 NXT for me.
Yeah.
It was an excellent show. So WrestleMania 6, yeah, NXT 9.5.
Yeah, I'll say 9.5 as well, because they can always do better.
Yeah.
So yeah. But it was amazing, mind blowing.
Yeah. WrestleMania weekend itself was excellent though. We had a lot of fun. We did the streams and we all hung out together and so it was a really good time. So we can at least thank WrestleMania for that.
Yeah, it was great. What about final scores for predictions? Me with 8 points and Sonny with 6. So that's a point for me. We'll add it to the winning total of tied bets.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So you've got 1 point for the PlayStation VR price prediction.
Yeah, and which I got dead on, by the way.
Yep, dead on. And I'll get a point for the WrestleMania predictions. And we'll do that from now on with pay-per-views and whatnot. Just for something.
Yeah, cool.
Loser does sort of forfeit or something at the end.
Yeah, sure, no problem. Sounds good. Okay, so... Cool.
That's that. That's WrestleMania.
Yeah, so Raw the next night.
Yes.
It started off... Vince McMahon came out.
He did.
That's what happened first, isn't it?
Yeah.
Vince came out, said how it was, how he was happy that sort of Undertaker won and that, Shane... basically had no chance in hell. And the crowd was singing his Vince McMahon's theme song as well, which is really cool. Vince basically acknowledged that the crowd were crazy that night.
Yeah, oh God, no, I hate how JBL was like, oh, the cheer for the guys who usually boo for and boo for the guys who you cheer for. Like,
yeah, shut no, up, they JBL. Don't.
No, they don't.
Yeah, you know full well they don't.
You're not fooling anyone. Shut up.
Yeah. Yeah, when I watched the show, I even said it out loud. I was like, that's a ridiculous thing to say.
Yeah.
Who does he think he's pulling the wool over their eyes there?
I think it's trying to convince casual fans that, oh, no, it really is. He is a good guy. It's just this weird day of weird crowd.
Yeah. All right. Well, what about next week when the booing rains out the building?
Yeah.
Either way, so Vince came out. The fans sung his theme song, which Vince clearly loved. He milked it.
Yeah.
Went in to sort of say that, you know, even though they didn't take a one, then it was great that Shane wasn't going to have control. You know, he did sort of, he couldn't believe that Shane had risked his life to gain control and all this sort of stuff. Vince was going to go into the back. Shane McMahon came out.
Mm-hmm. Here comes the money.
Yeah, so he sort of limped out very, very slowly.
Mm-hmm. Big old bruise in his face.
And just came out to say goodbye. Incredible ovation for him again.
Yeah.
You know, they were chanting Shane O'Mac and all this, you know, all the rest of it. And it was really cool. And I thought, he just came out to say bye. He was going to walk it to the back. And Vince, for no reason at all, probably just to keep the peace with the fans, maybe, because he did acknowledge it a couple of times that it was a crazy crowd. And they just chant what they want and all this other stuff. So he's like, well, Shane, you can have control of Monday Night Raw. And that was that. That was the end of that first segment. And we were like, okay, that's weird.
Yeah.
Show me what you've got. Okay, I guess.
Was it referenced Lockbox again?
Oh, they closed that chapter once and for all.
Yeah. I don't know. Part of me thinks there might be something else later.
I think that is it. No more Lockbox, no more secrets. And I was like, you sneaky bastard.
What was the point?
Yeah, you so sneaky with that. Like, yeah. Ugh. Yeah, so that's cool. So Shane's going to be in charge of Monday Night Raw.
Cool.
There was a lot of matches that I wasn't really interested in on Raw this week. Let's just talk about the notable bits and bobs.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so Apollo Crews debuted on Raw.
He did. Yeah,
came up from the main roster, and you know, won his match against Tyler Breeze.
Yep, poor Tyler.
Pretty quick time.
Yeah.
You said earlier on that you thought it was too soon for Apollo.
I just think, I don't know, it seems like he's been rushed a bit. Because although he's very good in the ring, is on the microphone is not that great. Not to say they can't improve. But it's just weird to see, because there are other people on the roster, like Finn Balor, Samoa Joe, a bunch of other people who've been on there way longer. He probably would be better suited. But
look at Apollo Crews.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, he's great. he looks great.
He is a Vince McMahon wrestler.
Yeah, that's true.
He is stacked.
Yeah.
He's got that look. He's like when Bobby Lashley was in WWE when he first came into it.
Yeah.
He looks like that. He's chiseled out of stone, Apollo Crews.
Yeah. It must have been Bobby Lashley was though.
He's a serious athlete as well.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's weird that, I tell you what I hate, is when they announce these things like, oh, Apollo Crews debuts after the break.
Yes.
What?
Surprise us. Don't tell us.
Have Tyler Breeze come down, get no reaction.
Yeah, poor Tyler.
And then like play Cruz's music and bring him out. Why'd you have to sort of ruin it? I don't get it.
Yeah. Weird.
But either way, I'm happy to see Apollo Crews on the main roster, and I think he'll do well.
Yeah, I think he will.
I think it'd be cool to see him sort of maybe inserted into the US title scene.
Yeah, sure.
Which on a side note wasn't even mentioned on Raw.
Yeah.
The US title has fallen so far down.
Yeah, that's what Cena was doing with it.
We didn't even mention Cena being at WrestleMania.
Oh, yeah. Cena did the thing with The Rock. That was weird. The Wyatt came out, had like a 3-second match with Eric Rowan.
How did we forget that?
Yeah.
I don't think we overly enjoyed that segment, though, either, did we?
Yeah, it was weird. This is wasting time. Because at this point, we'd super tired. It's like, let's want to see wrestling.
Yeah. Just show us Roman Reigns winning the title, please.
Yeah.
Oh, The Rock came down, set his name on fire, which is weird. Yeah. Then the Wyatts came down, and The Rock beat Rowan in record time, and then the Wyatts came in, then Cena came back. Finn was absolutely delighted. It was so happy.
Yeah.
And Cena and The Rock cleared house. That's it. That's the end of that. Right. Yep. back to Raw. The US title slipped down so far since Cena had it that I don't know.
It's bizarre.
It needs new life breathing into it.
Yeah.
I think putting it on Apollo Crews or someone like that you know, have Corbin and Cruz and these people, Ziggler, and have them fighting for the US title, make it mean something again.
Yeah, because a lot of attention gets put on the Intercontinental title.
Yeah.
And just like split that between that and also the US champion. And
yeah.
Yeah.
Or don't have it at all.
Yeah, we'll scrap it.
Otherwise, what's the point?
Yeah.
Because no one wants Ryback to have it. It's crap.
No. Maybe like unify it with the Intercontinental title or something.
Yeah.
So get rid of it.
Maybe. I like the idea of a second sort of mid-tier championship.
Yeah.
Because there's enough guys on the card to carry it.
For sure. I did think...
They're just not doing it.
Yeah. I did think, after all, because, like, obviously, they had, like, the Fatal 4-Way match for the number one contendership with AJ Styles, Sami Zayn, Kevin Owens, and other.
Mm-hmm.
Jericho, that was it.
Yeah.
Because I'm thinking they might put Owens and Sami Zayn towards the main event more, which is good. And they have guys like Zack Ryder and The Miz go for the Intercontinental title. And as well, can like bring using up like guys on the bottom of the card that don't use much and bringing them into like the Intercontinental title and US title a bit more. And split the card up a bit more nicely.
Yeah, I agree.
I thought that'd be cool.
That would be cool. I agree. But I think they need to sort of do something good going forward with Apollo just to avoid him getting lost in the shuffle.
Yeah. Don't make him another Tyler Breeze.
Yeah. So, I mean, he had a squash match with Tyler Breeze. I don't see Apollo going down that route, to be honest. He's more of a believable character.
I think so.
Tyler Breeze works in NXT. Mm. I like Tyler Breeze, but it's the same thing with Adam Rose. Adam Rose came up to the main roster.
Yeah.
And did nothing, and now he's in the Social Outcasts. And Tyler Breeze has come up to the main roster, and I saw like a staggering statistic that Tyler Breeze is like 0-49 since January.
Oh god, poor Tyler.
Jesus, I mean, I don't know, but yeah, I don't see Cruz going down that way. I think he'll do something worthwhile.
Yeah, I hope so.
Sooner rather than later, too.
For sure.
What else is notable about Raw? They had the Divas title the women's title presentation.
Mm-hmm.
The
crowd triangle Bayley.
Yeah, the crowd were going ape shit for Bayley.
I think everyone was expecting her to come down. And
yeah. I mean, Charlotte was, you know, acknowledging it, and they were singing Bayley and all this sort of stuff. Didn't happen, obviously. It will.
It will.
At some point. I'm not sure when, but it will.
For sure.
Yeah. Obviously, they unveiled they officially presented Charlotte with the belt.
Yep.
All the Divas were in the ring. Or are they women now? I don't know. Is that what they're called now?
I'm not sure what's
this. Is Total Divas going to be called Total Women?
good question. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't know. But
as you said, all the women in this ring did the best, and obviously didn't realise even we were standing behind her.
Yeah. sort of everyone after sort of Charlotte was thanking everybody and saying this is how it should be, and then sort of went on to brag about how she won the match and all this sort of stuff, and then obviously everyone sort of cleared off.
Mm-hmm.
Natalia stayed behind.
Oh yeah.
They didn't have a match, did they?
I don't think so. He's just like
Natalia got her in a sharpshooter though, didn't she?
Yeah, that sounds right.
I'm happy for that to happen going forward. I'd quite like to see Charlotte versus Natalia again.
Yeah,
pay-per-view.
Same.
That'd be good.
Yeah, it'd be cool.
Natty's a great wrestler. Charlotte is obviously a great wrestler.
Mm-hmm.
And it makes sense though as well.
It does.
And so underused Natalia is.
Yeah, for sure. She deserves way more.
So that happened. So it looks like they're sort of starting Natalia versus Charlotte.
Yep.
I mean, Sasha Banks was in a squash match earlier on Raw. She beat Summer Rae.
Oh yeah, you didn't see.
For no reason at all.
Yeah.
Fine. Okay.
It's fine.
Just have Sasha Banks on Raw, I guess.
Yeah.
So that's going to be cool going forward.
Yep.
They had Baron Corbin made his Raw debut.
He did.
Did standing next to the Andre the Giant Battle Royal trophy.
Yeah.
Cut a little promo saying that, you know, very standard heel stuff.
Yeah.
Nobody can get in my way, and I'm unstoppable and all this sort of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Ziggler came out. They had a match that ended in a no contest, I think.
Yeah, it was count out because
they went into the crowd, didn't they?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then Baron Corbin did the end of days on the outside of the ring.
Yeah. I thought he looked very good coming out of it.
It's a good start for that. Ziggler's probably the right person to put him with.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. That's cool. So, I mean, obviously, what Raw served a purpose for is setting matches up, setting rivalries up, probably from Payback beyond.
Yeah, definitely.
So that's cool. I think if they're going to go with Corbin and Ziggler, and they'll probably have that match at Payback, that'd be really good.
Yeah.
So it's good to see Baron Corbin on the main roster. To be honest, I think I said while I was to my girlfriend while I was watching the NXT show, that their acts, both Apollo Crews and Baron Corbin, they're not really going anywhere in NXT.
That's true.
You know, they're fine to fill the card and stuff like that, but, you know, they'd probably be better served on the main roster.
Yeah, that's true. And it makes way for newer guys as well to come up.
Mm.
So that's cool. I'm fine with it.
So maybe when Corbin sort of beats Ziggler in this feud, he will move on to either the IC or the US title as well. So yeah, it'd be cool to see Corbin and Cruz fighting for the US title, or at least in and around it.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
So that's another notable part of Raw. What else we got?
The Whites came down and maybe turned face, kind of. Because they beat up the League of Nations.
Oh, yeah.
They kicked out Wade Barrett because he's leaving soon. Spoilers.
Yep.
So, yeah, weird.
Yeah. It was a weird episode of Raw, actually. I mean, I enjoyed it. It was fine.
Yeah.
But it was weird. I mean, yeah, Wade Barrett, probably you won't see him much anymore.
Probably not.
He might maybe have a one-on-one match with one of them at Payback, and then you maybe never see him again.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so the Whites came down, beat up the League of Nations. League of Nations then excommunicated Wade Barrett,
mm-hmm.
saying he was the weak link, even though he just stands outside the ring in his pants. Yeah. He can be the weak link. I don't know. But,
who knows?
Yeah, so that was good. Obviously, Shane made the match for the number one contendership for the World Championship.
Yep.
Because Roman Reigns came down to booze.
Yeah, more booze. I thought it was a decent promo for him. He's just like, I'm not a bad guy, I'm not a good guy, I'm the guy.
Yeah.
That's what he needs. He doesn't need all this crazy, like, oh, sucker in sucker tears. Look how crazy and wacky I am. Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, he's not... Yeah.
He's just a man of few words, a badass kind of guy. That's all he needs.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree. I liked it. And then, obviously, Sammy came down. AJ Styles came down first, I think.
You think so?
Jericho came down. Then AJ came down.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Jericho, all people. And then, like, a bunch more.
Yeah, so, and then obviously afterwards they all fought and Roman Reigns just walked off.
Yeah, so whoop. This is awkward, I'm off.
And then Shane made the match, Fatal Four Way. Well, the four guys that came down, obviously, to fight Roman Reigns for the title whenever.
Yeah.
This was a great match. So I was looking forward to that as well.
Yeah, that was awesome.
That's pretty cool. I mean, Shane really didn't do a lot on Raw.
Yeah, a lot of people said Shane McMahon's Raw was a lot like Vince's Raw.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot like that.
Yeah.
But, you know, they showed him talking to Apollo Crews like it was Shane who yeah. made the decision to bring him up and all this sort of stuff. But,
oh, hey, man, yeah.
Yeah. That was a cool thing. I've got a good main event to look forward to here.
Yeah.
Jericho will probably win. So that's fine. Kalisto, like I said before, the US title wasn't even on Raw.
Nope.
New Day were on Raw.
I think so, yeah.
And they talked about the WrestleMania getting stunned and all that sort of stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Did they even have a match or?
I don't remember. I don't think they did.
Yeah, I can't remember.
Who knows?
Okay, so then going into the third hour, you had the Dudleys versus the Usos in a tables match.
Oh, yeah.
Which, once again, was...
Fine,
whatever it was.
Had a weird ending that didn't... Because like, the Usos jumped through a table, which apparently doesn't count. Properly, needs to be put through a table.
Yeah.
And the ref rang the bell anyway, and Demon got pissed.
Yeah. Bubba Ray got pissed off as well.
Yeah.
Like, now we've won, like when they actually did win.
Yeah, but now we've won.
Yeah, and then it cut to commercial break, then it came back, and the Dudleys were still there, and I was like, what? And then Enzo and Cass made their debut.
Yeah, I thought about that. That's awesome.
No Carmella.
Yeah.
So obviously, Carmella's not being brought up with them.
That's fine. I think she's still got stuff to work on in NXT.
Yeah, I think so, yeah. I like Carmella as well. I was a little disappointed that she wasn't there, but I can see why she wasn't there at the same time.
Yeah.
And they came out and did a really hilarious promo.
Yeah.
Sort of slating the Dudleys. And
it was awesome.
Yeah, it was really cool. So it was awesome to see them. They deserve to come up.
Definitely. They've been on NXT long enough.
Yes. 3 NXT call-ups during Raw this week. So Apollo Crews, Baron Corbin, and Enzo and Cass.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Which was excellent. Then we had the main event,
mm-hmm.
Which was the Fatal 4-Way. Yep. Really good match. Best Raw main event for ages.
Yeah, definitely. 4 great guys.
Yeah.
Very
surprised when AJ Styles won.
Yeah, it's so good.
That's going to be cool.
Yeah, I wonder if they're going to try and maybe turn Roman heel, or just going to keep him like in between good and bad kind of thing.
I thought the Bullet Club might come in to help or beat up AJ on Raw.
Oh, yeah.
I know they were backstage. I know Anderson and Gallows were backstage.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Cool.
They were in Dallas. Obviously, didn't come out and do anything, but maybe, you know, they might turn on
maybe
AJ and go with Reigns.
Maybe, yeah. Maybe during Payback they'll come up and journey main event.
Maybe. I mean, I don't see AJ winning.
No, I'd be surprised. I mean, I'd like to see it.
Yeah, me too.
I'd like to see AJ Styles with the WWE Championship. Mm. But it won't happen.
No, it won't happen.
not ending 1 month into Reigns' as title run.
No. I think what we're going to get coming out of this is AJ Styles versus Roman Reigns, obviously.
Yep.
We're going to have a Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn singles feud.
Yep.
And I think... because Ambrose wasn't on Raw, was he?
I don't think so.
But I think, based on something that happened on SmackDown, he's going to go into a feud with Jericho.
Cool, okay.
Because that was the feud that was supposed to go into WrestleMania 32, but it was changed due to injuries and stuff like that. So they're going to go forward with that now, which I'm fine with. That'd be awesome.
That'd be cool. And the Ford Villains as well, they made a debut on SmackDown.
They did this week, which is a weird one, actually.
Yeah, Tyler Breeze made his debut on SmackDown as well, and that didn't turn out too well for him.
No. one thing we haven't talked about is the IC title.
Oh, yeah.
This is why I said that Zack Ryder winning the ladder match was pointless.
Yeah.
So what happened was we had Zack Ryder versus The Miz.
Mm-hmm.
Rematch. Because The Miz came out and said that Zack Ryder cost him the IC title and all this sort of stuff. The match was okay.
It was fine.
Then The Miz went outside and Zack Ryder's dad was at ringside.
Yep, in Superman, in a
Superman
shirt.
T-shirt.
looking bright red.
Yep. Looking absolutely jacked.
Yeah.
Zack Ryder's dad pushed The Miz over.
Mm-hmm.
And then Maryse came out of nowhere.
Yeah, The Miz's wife.
The Miz's wife, Maryse, somehow.
Yeah, it's lucky.
Punching man. Above his weight again.
Yeah, definitely.
She came out of nowhere, slapped Zack Ryder's dad. Zack Ryder was stunned by all of this, looking into what was going on. Miz hit the score-crushing finale, 1-2-3, wins the title.
Yeah.
I was fine with it.
Yeah. I think they're going to feud. I think Zack's actually going to win it back at Payback or whatever. It sets up a good feud, good mid-card feud. As I said earlier, if it means Owens and Sami Zayn is going to be in the main event, I'm perfectly happy to see Zack Ryder and The Miz in mid-card.
Because they could also have good matches. I don't mind The Miz.
No, I like The Miz.
And I like Zack Ryder fine.
Yeah, yeah.
They brought Maryse back because she's going to be in the next season of Total Divas.
Oh, is she?
Yeah.
You mean I like Maryse? Maryse? That's her name after she made Miz.
I hope Zack Ryder's dad's not going to be in the next series of Total Divas.
Yeah.
But
I like Maryse. It's good to see her back.
I don't even know what she does these days.
Yeah,
so
me
now
too.
She's back anyways. And
I doubt she'll be wrestling, but it's cool to see her. That's like,
I think she might.
Really?
I think what they could do, because obviously Emma is the real life girlfriend of Zack Ryder.
Oh yeah.
So maybe they could sort of mix tag it up along the way.
It could do.
And they can have Maryse sort of come back into it.
True, but Emma's sort of a heel though, isn't she? So it'd be a bit weird.
Well, I don't know.
I think it turned. I don't know. Who knows? It's weird. Main card stuff.
Although we've talked about it sort of arse backwards, Raw was... It was a good episode of Raw. It was a good...
It was solid.
Post-Mania episode of Raw.
Yeah.
It gave us what we wanted to see with AJ Styles winning and becoming number one contender. Good feel-good moment for him afterwards as well when Raw went off air.
Mm-hmm.
Like they showed the footage and stuff on Facebook, which was cool.
Yeah.
Cool. So, quick recap of Raw. Apollo Crews made his debut.
Yep. Baron Corbin.
Baron Corbin made his debut.
Yep.
The IC title changed hands, and The Miz is now the champion, and Maryse has come back.
Yeah.
Enzo and Cass made their debut,
And
I think probably set up a feud with
the
Dudley Boys.
Yep, that'd be great.
And then AJ Styles became the one contender for the WWE title.
Yeah, which is awesome.
So, good episode of Raw all around.
Yeah.
Be interesting to see sort of where things go forward, you know, starting on Raw this week. I'm already looking forward to watching Raw this week already.
Yeah, me too, actually.
So that's good. I mean, at least they've given us that, because most of the time I don't look forward to seeing
No, it's just another thing to do.
Yeah, like I feel like we have to do.
Yeah.
Let's skip most of it. But I'm looking forward to seeing Raw this week. I'm looking forward to seeing Cruz. I'm looking forward to seeing Corbin and Enzo and Cass. And so it's good. But as Finn pointed out, the Vaude Villains made their debut on SmackDown this week.
Yeah.
They beat Kalisto and Sin Cara.
Oh, yeah. That was it.
Quickly, apparently, as well.
Oh, right. Okay.
I don't know what this means for the Lucha Dragons. I don't know what this means for Kalisto. I do like the Vaude Villains, but why have debuts on SmackDown? It's stupid.
It is stupid. It's very stupid.
I don't know if it's to get viewers or what, but I haven't seen it myself.
I haven't either.
It'd be interesting to see what sort of reaction they get, but it's difficult to tell on SmackDown because of the piped in crowd noises and stuff. So,
yeah, I hate that.
I'll catch it. I might watch it later on and I'll tweet about it or something. I don't know. That's pretty much all we've got to talk about today.
Pretty much.
Mania was good. We enjoyed it. If you were involved in our WrestleMania weekend, our first WrestleMania weekend as a show, we thank you.
Yes, thank you much.
And more of the same next year.
Yep.
So, yeah, it's great. So, that's, unless you've got anything else you want to talk about?
I think that's about it.
Good. Right. So thank you very much for listening. This is episode 8 of the Sunny and Finn Show. Mm-hmm. Check out our YouTube, check out our Twitter at SunnyFinnPC. We're also on Instagram and Facebook.
Yes.
But that's all for now. We will speak to you again soon. Thank you very much.
Thanks very much. Goodbye.